Randeep ji, you can start the meeting.
Okay, sir. Good morning, one and all. Myself, I'm Kirandeep. I'm one of this member of this Jeevan Yogasana team. I welcome everyone to this session. I hope everybody. Okay, let me start this. Today, I'm very glad to see you all in this meeting because we are going to share a lot of knowledge on the basic and important thing of our. Okay, let us start this meeting with a prayer by Lanka Satyanarayan Garu, Jeevan Yogasana team. Here, we are collaborated with V. Prasanna Kumar Garu. Now, let us start this session with a prayer by Lanka Satyanarayan Garu, Jeevan Yogasana.
Thank you, Dutti. Now, close your eyes. 3 times Omkaram, Guru Mantra. Om. Om Namo Brahmadibhyo Brahma Vidya Sampradaya Katrubhyo Vamsa Rushubhyo Mahabhyo Namo Gurubhyaha Om Guru Brahma Guru Devo Maheswaraha Guru Sakshat Parabrahma Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Om Sahanavavatu Sahanau Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahai Tejasvina Vaditamastu Mavit Vishavahai Om Ashatoma Sadgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mruchorma Amrutamaya Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Thank you.
Today, I'm very glad to see you all here in the session because we are going to share a lot of knowledge on the basic and important thing of our life, that is our health. I said it as a basic and important thing because we all know that health is everything, and if health is lost, everything is lost. So, in keeping this in mind, Jeevan Yogasana is organizing a national health webinar on obesity problems. That means today we are going to know about obesity problems. That means what is obesity, what are its ill effects, how can we overcome obesity, and etc. etc. For this, I honorably welcome our chief guest, G. Premana Galu, to hand over the session. Her educational qualifications are, she studied at Space Center School in Sriharikota. She completed her degree BA. She was honored with many awards like Yoga Bhushan Award in 2016 by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. And also, she was honored with Yoga Pratibha Puraskar by Shivajyoti Yoga Kendra at Bangalore in 2017. And also she was honored with many prestigious awards like Yoga Charni Award by Shivajyoti Yoga Kendra at Bangalore in 2017. She started her yoga career in 2007. She worked at center in charge at Bharati Yoga Samsthan, Osmania University. And also she won many medals like bronze medal at AP State Yogasana Championship, Hyderabad, and also many awards which are in her biodata, like one gold medal in first Telangana state level yoga championship at Nizamabad, and she won fourth place in national level yoga championship held at New Delhi in 26th April, and also she won national gold medal in Howrah district bodybuilding and yoga association in 10th to 12th September. She won bronze medal in 35th national yoga championship 2017 held from 21st to 23rd April. And also, she won bronze medal in 36th National Yoga Championship 2018, held from 6th to 8th April in 2018. And many which were not addressed now, she won many medals. So I request her to hand over this session and make you all clear in this. Thank you. I honorably welcome Pramila ma'am to hand over the session.
Pranam to everyone. Good morning. I am here today. I am very thankful to everyone. I think everyone are ready for this session. Today our session is upon obesity, yoga therapy on obesity. So we are going to go on with obesity. What are the asanas and pranayama and what are the workouts we are going to do? I'll tell you. And if you are having any doubts, you can ask in chat. And in the last, we'll give you a question session. So let us know about our obesity today. So I hope so many are well known nowadays about obesity problems. So many are facing obesity problems. So let us start today our program. Yoga therapy for obesity. So today we are going to know about obesity. So next one. So obesity, excessive amount of body fat, women will be having 35% of body fat and men will be having 25% of body fat, because men are getting less percentage because they are going outside and the physical activity will be more. Whereas ladies, they will be working at home. So that is the increased risk for health problems are usually overweight, but can have healthy BMI and high percent fat. So desirable percentage of body fat is men 8% to 25% and women whereas 20 to 35%. So next we are going for obesity. Obesity, 25% of men and 40% of women are trying to lose weight. Obesity is a chronic disease. Treatment requires long-term lifestyle changes. So more concerned about weight loss than healthy lifestyle. Unrealistic weight expectations. So symptoms of obesity are breathlessness, increased sweating. So some people will be getting more sweating. So who are having the obesity problems, who are facing the obesity problems, they will be having more sweating. Then snoring in the sleeping times, there will be snoring. And inability to cope with the sudden physical activity, feeling very tired every day. For small things also, they will be getting tiredness and they can't do more work as active as possible without. So feeling very tired every day, back to joint pains also. And back pains will be getting back pains and joint pains because of the overweight. So if you reduce the weight, then they will not get the back pains and joint pains much. Low confidence and self-esteem, feeling isolated. So what are the effects? So the effects means, because of obesity, we will be getting some problems that causes all cause of death. So such as high blood pressure and LDL cholesterol, high LDL cholesterol and low HDL cholesterol, or high levels of everything, so many things. So type 2 diabetes, coronary heart diseases, strokes, gallbladder diseases, osteoarthritis. So such as I think so many are facing the osteoarthritis problems. That is bone problems. The bones will be very delicate, and so breathing block, breathing problems, and sleeping many times of many types of cancer, also low quality of life. So mentally illness such as clinical depression, anxiety, and other mental disorders, body pain and difficulty with physical functioning, to do any work, will be feeling a laziness. So what to eat? So many will be taking their diet, and so many people will be telling that I'm taking perfect diet for obesity, such as everything what we should eat and what we should not do, we're following the diet. But they don't know what to eat and which time we should take and how much we should take. So that is very important. So please try to take good calories. So calories matter for weight, and some foods make it easier for us to keep our calories in check. Healthy eating is a key to good health as well as maintaining a healthy weight. It's not only what and how much we eat, but also it seems how we eat that's important. So what to eat? Choose minimally processed whole foods such as whole grains, whole wheat, steel, cut oats, brown rice, etc. And vegetables, a colorful variety, not potatoes, whole fruits. Don't take fruits, because fruit contains high level of fibers, and if you take the juices, you will not get the fiber content. So next, we can take nuts, seeds, beans, and other healthful sources of protein. Fish and poultry, so plant oils like olive oil, another safflower oil. Safflower oil is very good for health. So we try to take safflower oil for everyone. And drink water, natural calories free. And what not to eat? Limit these foods and drinks. Sugar sweetened beverages, soda, fruit drinks, soft sports drinks, fruit juice, no more than a small amount per day. Refined grains, white bread, white rice, white pasta, and sweets, potatoes, baked or fried. So red meat, beef, pork, lamb, and processed meats, salmia, ham, and bacon, sausage, with other highly processed foods such as fast food also you should avoid. So next, because I'm completing the PPT now, so that when we'll go for pranayama and meditation, we can do the physically completely exercises. So I'm giving the complete PPT in first. So we should avoid watching TVs and sitting more time in one place. So when we are playing or when we are watching the TV, video games, like that. So try to avoid the TVs and that's sitting for more time. And now we'll go for yoga for obesity. So I think so many are doing physical exercises. So physical exercises and pranayama will be going, we'll go start first slowly, such as we'll go for warm-up exercise first. So I think you can practice with me if you can. So let us see once. So we'll go for physical exercise first. So before doing the asanas, we'll go for some simple warm-up exercise. Without warm-up exercise, we should not do the asanas or pranayamas. So first, let us start with warm-up exercises. First, we should just Tadasan, free movement.
Please make your screen big. We are not able to see you. You're just coming at the side of the screen.
Okay.
So either make it the full screen, please. Like where the you are sharing the PPT, please share your screen. Yes, now it's okay.
Yeah. Is it clear? Yeah, now we can go for a simple Tadasana. Take your hands up. Stretch. Just loosen your spine. And stay there for a few seconds. And then slowly come back. When you are doing any Tadasana or any asanas, you should stretch your complete body with relaxation. Don't take any risk. So just once again, let us go for one more. We'll go for hands lifting up and then taking your hands back. This is very simple exercise which we can warm up our body and then going back and turning your elbows up and your palms to your shoulder, back shoulder blades. And then again, inhale and again, go front and relaxing, come back. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Exhale. Okay. And then exhale, relax your body. So this makes our body relax. This is very good for warming our body. And the same thing, we go for second set. Take your left leg forward and then your right leg back. So again, inhale, lift your hands up and take your palms to your shoulders and then exhale, going back and turn your leg also. Inhale, again coming to front. Exhale, going back. Inhale, coming front. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. This is very easy. And you can able to do this one very easily. So now let us go for Tadasana once again with counting. Just now take your hands up. Inhale, stretch your hands up. Coming up, coming to Tadasana, interlock your hands and then lift your hands up as much as you can. Stretch your body up, stretch your spine up, and stay there for a while. You can count for 30 seconds. You can stay there for 30 seconds. Now lift your heels up. So I can see my toes. Lift your heels up and stay there for a few seconds. Some may stay for 30 seconds. Some may stay for more than 30 seconds. Some can stay for 15 seconds. So as what is the capacity you can stay. Exhale, coming back with the stretching. The same thing. Now we are going to do same in Tadasana. We will do some walkings on your heels and on your toes. So I'm taking from here on your mat. Take both the hands up. Lift your heels up. Stand on your toes. And walk slowly. Only your fingertips, your toes. You should walk on your toes. slowly the practice you can do. As much as you can do it, no problem. Now walk on your heels. Take your toes up and walk on your heels slowly. Your heels. Your body weight completely should be on the middle of your heels. So that your toes will get relaxed. Now, let us go over some hand exercises which makes our body flexible, our hands flexible. So, we'll go for some small warm-ups like this. You can make 5 count and you can start with 5 too. You can increase the count for 10 count also, like this. This makes your nerves and your muscles, your hands strengthens. Because of obesity, will become little bit weak. Will lose some strength in our body because of the obesity. So now let us go for Tadasana for staying with time. So count start from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Now interlock and stay there for 30 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Now again coming back for 30 count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. So like this, we should do Tadasana so that our body completely will be warm up. Now let us go for asanas. So I think you know asanas. Which we are showing, I'll tell about the asanas now. So now let us go for asanas. The asanas and pranayama, which will help for obesity. So Kapalbhati pranayama and meditation can help the weight loss. Next, Santalanasana. That means plank pose, Chaturangasana. So Chaturangasana is plank pose. So side plank pose we can do. Normal plank pose we can do. Chaturanga Dandasana means four limbs pose. And Chakrasana, back bending, that is wheel pose. We can do Chakrasana with lying down or you can do with ball support also. So first you should do warm-ups for when we are doing these asanas. So to our workout routine, practicing this effective combination of yoga asana, pranayama and meditation techniques will help you with a more long-term weight loss. So if you practice daily, you will get definitely the result. So next, according to weight loss statistics, there are 1 billion overweight adults in the world, among which 62.9% have reported exercising is a common method to come out of obesity. So the easiest among all exercise methods is to take conscious breathing, that is pranayama. So yes, breathing techniques of pranayama can help you with weight loss. So when we are doing the pranayama, our stomach should be empty. So if you are doing the pranayama, you can do in the early hours, means with empty stomach. So as we know, pranayama is deep and conscious breathing in which oxygen supply increases to cellular community of our body. So when we are breathing, our complete cells will be activated. So to the increase in the oxygen supply, metabolism becomes super active in the body. So thus it is BMI. So if you check the BMI, then you can go for this. First we should check the BMI, then only we will start the obesity therapy. So next, a superactive metabolism simply means burning a higher number of calories. The higher the metabolic rate is, quickly you lose the weight. So now let us go for pranayama. So what is the pranayama? Pranayama reduces BMI. During pranayama, excess weight flies as CO2, that is carbon dioxide. There is a Kapalbhati pranayama. So active exhalation and passive inhalation. So forcefully exhalation of air activates the abdominal muscles, which helps in the removal of excess fat and toning of the abdomen. When we are exhaling, Kapalbhati will be exhaling. Our concentration should be on our breath in exhalation only, not in inhalation. Inhalation takes automatically. So we should take only, your concentration should be on exhalation. So forceful exhalation of air activities and abdominal muscles will be squeezing inside. So which helps in the removal of excess. So deep inhalation helps in the pouring of a good amount of oxygen into the circulatory system, which enhances metabolism. So avoid exposure of the cold water. When you want to reduce your weight, you should take hot water, lukewarm water. No, don't take cold water. Air conditions you should avoid. Surroundings right of the practice. Research has found that practicing Kapalbhati pranayama helps in the reduction of the waist and hips circumferences, which ultimately helps in weight loss. So you should take hot water, and daily you should go for pranayama. Hot water, warm water helps a lot. So Anulom Vilom Pranayama is very easy, at the same time very tough, because so many people will be thinking that inhalation and exhalation is only the Anulom Vilom. But when you are doing in Anulom Vilom Pranayama, this is Sukhamaya Pranayama. At the same time, this is very best asana you can do easily. If you keep the concentration and do the Anulom Vilom Pranayama, you get benefit, more of benefit from Anulom Vilom. So alternative breathing. Anulom Vilom means inhalation starts from left side and exhale from right side. And again, inhale from right side and we'll go for exhalation from left side. This is one cycle, one round it will go. So when you are inhaling and when you are exhaling, first in starting in basic level, you take for 3 seconds. 3 seconds you can take inhalation slowly and exhalation slowly for 3 seconds. Then when you increase the second time of inhalation and exhalation, then you'll get exact benefit. So alternative breathing. Fat acquired due to the hormonal imbalance is settled by long inhalation in Anulom Vilom. Further, it improves metabolism and ultimate activated endocrine glands. So it removes toxins from the blood, which prevents the supply of oxygenated blood to the fat stored muscles. So when you are doing the Anulom Vilom Pranayama, our nerves, so blood circulation will be perfectly activated. So it will be purified, and then we'll go for Bhramari Pranayama. Bhramari Pranayama is, we'll do with closing of our ears, and then we'll keep our thumb finger in the ears. So the index finger will go for on the eyebrows and your middle finger under your eyeballs. Then your ring finger on your upper lip, and then your little finger under the lip. So now like this, you'll take the hands and you'll be first remove your thumbs from your ears and first inhale. We'll inhale completely and then we'll close the ears and we'll say makar. So in this, just like a bee, just like a bee will be taking the inhalation. The sound comes like a bee, honeybee or anything like bees, how it sounds. The same way we'll take. So like this, the humming of the bee. So in this breathing, Brahmari Pranayama, in this breathing, you need to produce a vibration through the throat. That vibration resembles sound of a bee. The same thing what I just said now, this is why humming bee breath is another name of the breathing technique. So Brahmari reduces weight by promoting the secretion of a certain hormone which acts as a stress buster, because stress is also a common cause of weight gain. So because of stress also, we'll get the obesity problems. So that is the reason so many people who are thinking more, they're having some problems, they'll be struggling with obesity problems. So they can do that as this Brahmari Pranayama also. So Brahmari promotes weight loss action. So it helps in overcoming respiratory ailments, which further promotes deep breathing and ultimately assists metabolic activity. So in Brahmari Pranayama and Anulom Vilom Pranayama, Anulom Vilom actually will go in the last, because that is Anulom Vilom Pranayama is called as Sukhamai Pranayama also, because it will calms down the our blood pressure and will be cool. So that is the reason Anulom Vilom Pranayama will do in the ending. So Brahmari also the same way. So Bhastrika Pranayama will be doing. This Bhastrika Pranayama helps, it activates our Surya Nadi and our Agni Tattvam will increase. So breath of fire, see Bhastrika Pranayama, breath of fire. This pranayama breathing involves the forceful inhalation and exhalation at the same pace. So inhalation and exhalation, it takes same force. So forceful inhalation and forceful exhalation. So we'll taking like this. Like this, we should inhale and we should exhale. So that force will be equal in inhalation and exhalation. Bhastrika Pranayama, which means breath of fire, is a very powerful exercise that could burn all your excess fat within a few months. So in that moment of inhalation and exhalation, we can keep our concentration on our abdomen also. So abdomen also moves front and back when you are forceful inhaling and exhaling. So when you are inhaling, your abdomen will be coming out. So when you are exhaling, your abdomen will be going inside. Forceful nature of Bhastrika Pranayama promotes the activeness of the muscles at the physical level, which helps in shedding of the stored fat. So it helps in the detoxification process by purifying the blood from various toxins, which hinder the active metabolism. So next we'll go for next pranayamas. So these are the pranayamas. So when you are doing this pranayamas regularly, so some of the pranayamas are also there, and we can do the Surya Namaskara also. Surya Namaskaras, sun salutations, actually so many people will be doing Surya Namaskara. Some people will be doing sun salutations per day only one round, and some people will be doing they'll start for 12 from 1 to next one 12 they will do, because in Surya Namaskara there are 12 steps, so they'll go for 12 rounds, and some people be increasing day by day as one or two Surya Namaskaras also. So like that we'll go for Surya Namaskara. So I'll show you everything now one by one. I'll show you pranayamas, and after that I will go for the Surya Namaskara, and we'll go for asanas also. There are 12 steps in Surya Namaskara. Each of those poses is accompanied with a sequence breathing, which if done with concentration and accuracy promotes weight loss, toning up your entire body. Means when we are doing Surya Namaskara, we are having some seven chakras, our complete body will be activated. So in those, when we are doing the each posture, our body will be activating from 1 to 12 postures we will be doing in the Surya Namaskara. In the 12 postures when we are doing, we can activate our complete body only with Surya Namaskara. The people who are not having time, some people are saying we are not having time to do asanas or pranayama, we can't do whole things and everything daily, we are in hurry, like that they'll be done. But if you are not having time, at least you can do Surya Namaskara, so that your body completely will be activated. With breath, you should do the Surya Namaskara. So you can, if you are not able to control the breath and you are not able to do, if you are having any high blood pressure or any heart problem, you should not hold the breath. And we'll go, we should do with normal breathing also, you can do, if you are not able to do with breath. Everything is sequence. So, seated spinal twist. These poses of yoga for breathing and weight loss will undoubtedly give you long-term benefits. Now, what are the some more asanas I can show? This is effective asanas, Trikonasana. So, Trikonasana, you can see here. See these hands. You are able to see this from up from. You can see some straight line of your hands, and here you can see your body same parallel to the ground. And here you can see the posture in how your legs should be in triangle pose here. So this is the posture. This is Trikonasana, means triangular pose. So you can do this triangular pose, and it affects very nice on your side, which is you are having the side effects. So any we can go for with breath also, you can go when you are going to the asana, and afterwards you can be in normal position when you are staying in the posture. So next, this is one asana, Trikonasana we are going to do, and this is Tadasana, just what I showed now. Tadasana, why we are doing this Tadasana? Tadasana means, you know that in Telugu they will be telling Tadchetu, like that. So this is the Tadasana. Your body will be in straight line, so that in this Tadasana, your body from top to bottom, from the bottom to top, completely your fingertips to your toes, it will be activated completely. So Tadasana is very important. In this Tadasana, you can do some small variations also, some small twistings and other things. So next, this is Pavan Muktasana. So Pavan Muktasana, this one releases your gases. Who are having some acidity problems, they can do this Pavan Muktasana, and this is very good for spine, and your abdomen muscles will be activated and your gas will be released. Your gas will be released from upper or lower, that means anus, from anus muscles, from anus muscles also we can release the gases. So never hold your anus muscles when you are doing the Pavan Muktasana. You should keep your anus muscles free. So this is Pavan Muktasana. This is called Pavan Muktasana. Means Pavan means air, Mukta means releasing. So releasing the air from our body. So this is Pavan Muktasana. Next, Uttanapadasana. Uttanapadasana means lifting our legs up to 90 degrees. So because of obesity, so many people can't lift the legs to 90 degrees because of the overweight of their thighs or extra anything else, because of the belly fat. So many people can't lift the knees straight also. So you can do in a basic, you can start slowly, you can go, and then I'll show you now how we are going to do this Uttanapadasana. Some people, how they can do, and some who are flexible, they will do. If they are overweight also, when they are obesity also, they can do, because their body is flexible. Whose body is flexible, they can do a little bit more perfect. So day by day, you can do perfectly. In the starting stage, you will see some small difficulties. So day by day, daily practice, you should make the yoga as a daily habit, as we are taking water and doing our daily habits like eating and sleeping, drinking. So the same thing we should go for yoga also. Our physical exercise also is very important for our body. So this is Bhujangasana. Bhujangasana means, that means snake pose. Bhujanga means snake. So Bhujang, just you can look at her, the posture here. Her body is straight. So you can see when the snake lifts its head, you can see like this, same lifting like this. So this is called Bhujangasana. So the posture will be like this. Your navel should touch your ground and your head should be straight. This is basic level. Your elbow should be in the standing posture. This is basic. So this one everyone can do in when they're having obesity also, no problem. So we'll go for next asana. Next, this is Shalabhasana. Look at him. He is doing Shalabhasana. His hands. Look at his hands. His hands, palms facing towards the mat. And he is lifting his legs straight without bending his knees. So you can do how much you can lift. You can lift to this level also. Slowly, day by day, you can lift up. And then you can go for this level. So this is some advanced level. So he lifted much. So now here you should keep your chin on the ground. Your chin on the mat. And then your hand should be straight under your thighs. Okay. This is the Shalabhasana. Shalabhasana means, I think you know, the grasshopper. So this is the posture of the grasshopper. Just like that. Next, we'll go for Kamar Chakrasana. This is Kamar Chakrasana. Kamar means, you know, obviously, Kamar means our waist. So we are rotating our waist. So when we are turning like this, we are rotating our waist. Then we are going to take our opposite hand to opposite leg. So when look at her, she is taking her hand to the opposite hand to opposite leg. So when she is turning, twisting her waist this side. So the same way your hand should be back. One hand should be around your waist backside and one hand straight touching the toe. So this way we will be doing this Kamar Chakrasana. This reduces our fat around our waist. And we'll go for next asana. This is Markatasana. Markatasana is complete twisting pose of our leg. In this posture also, you are going to reduce your thigh muscle fat and your buttocks muscles fat. And this, at the same time, it will be mostly activated our abdomen. Just like we're twisting our abdomen completely, your waist will be twisting side completely. So we should take like this, our opposite hand to opposite leg. Your leg will be lifting first to 90 degrees and then we'll go for twisting to opposite side. But here, when we are taking the leg to other side, second side, opposite side, your other shoulders should be on the ground. You should not lift your, automatically it raises. Your hand automatically raises and your shoulder also, this side will be lifting up. So you should keep your concentration here, not to lift your hand and your shoulder. You should not move this place. So you can, your facing should be straight to the roof. So this is called Markatasana. In this position, you should not bend your knees. This one should be careful. Here your knee should be straight. If you are not able to do, you can take the support of anyone and then you can do this Markatasana, no problem. So next, Vajrasana. Vajrasana, I think so many know about Vajrasana because normally we'll be sitting like this in daily after when we are relaxing, sometime we'll be sitting like this. So who are in obesity, so they can't sit because of the heaviness of the body. So such kind of people can sit on the cushion, on beds or any sofas, you can sit, but your spine should be straight. Look at him, his buttocks on his, in between his heels. So both the heels will be outside and in between both the heels, he will keep your buttocks, bumps will be in between both the heels. So your toes will be in stretching position. So your big toe will be side by side. So here your knees, both the knees should be joined and your hands will be on your palms should be on your knees. So here look at him, the spine is straight. This one you should keep your concentration. Vajrasana, you should keep your spine straight, because our spine will be straight means you will not get any health issues. If your spine is healthy, your spine is flexible, you can do anything. So because of age, our spine will be getting stiffness, it will become harder. So we should do, if you are doing the daily exercises or daily asanas, so then you will not get the spine stiffness, and because of your food habits also, your spine will get stiff. So this is the Vajrasana. Because what is the benefits of Vajrasana? Your joints will be strong and your joint pains will go, and your digestion will be perfect. After your food, you can sit like this daily. You can practice first in basic level. You can sit for 5 minutes or 2 minutes. Then like that, from 2 minutes to 5 minutes, from 5 minutes to 10 minutes, like that, you can go on increase the sitting posture like this. So if you make this one as a daily habit, after taking food for 5 minutes, you will sit here like this. Your foot will be digested in time and you will not get any joint pains, and your complete waist level fat and thigh level fat will be in normal. So this is Vajrasana. So I'll go for next. This is Paschimottanasana. Paschimottanasana, this is forward bending pose. See here, look at him. He is completely, his body is touching, your upper body is touching his thighs. No gap in between his thighs and upper body. So his forehead is below his knees, near the before calf muscles. So he is touching his top of the head to the toes, and he is holding the toes. Here he is perfectly doing the Paschimottanasana. This reduces your abdominal fat, so that your bums fat also will be decreases. So here your abdominal fat will decrease and your bums, because the both are stretching, and so you can see the posture here. This is Paschimottanasana, keeping your forehead to your knees. Next, Purvottanasana. After doing the Paschimottanasana, we are completely in Paschimottanasana, we are bending forward and we are not no gap in between your upper body and lower body. So in this next asana which we are doing after Paschimottanasana, because we are stretching our body over, we are opening our body completely in this posture. See the posture here. Look at her toes are touching the mat. Toes should be completely stretched. So in the beginning, you may not touch the toes to ground, because it may be quite some difficulty. So by practice, you can do like this. So you complete your foot on the mat like this. Your toes will be stretching the mat. Here, ankles will be stretched from toes to the complete top of the head. Your body will be in stretching position. So in this stretching position, your body comes just like Tadasana. You see, when we are doing the Tadasana, we are stretching completely up, so that our body from top to bottom, we are getting activated. The same way here also, our body completely activates, but here our body weight will be on our hands, wrist. So our shoulders and hands will be bearing our weight. So if you can't stay for more time, then you can stay for few seconds, and then you can slowly drop your waist slowly down, and then you can relax, and again you can lift slowly up. So that is the reason when we are having obesity, we can't do you can stay in much time in one posture. So let us do slowly basic. You can lift up and come back, and again lift up and come in again, come back. So in that way you can do slowly, you can increase the time also. Here the body completely weight is here, and then your buttocks will be squeezed and tighten your buttocks. So that is the way here your buttocks will be in squeezing position here, and your thighs will be in squeezing position, kneecaps also, and your body completely stiff here. So you can see straight, you are keeping more effort here, so that we can, this is quite opposite to plank pose. So next asana, Navkasana. Navkasana means just like a boat pose. You can see boat shape like here. Look at this. He is in a boat pose. You can see this is Navkasana. This is Navkasana. This one we can do the same pose Navkasana in opposite way also, in lying on our spine. This is prone. This is actually we are doing this pose, is this Navkasana is in prone posture. We can do the same Navkasana in supine posture also. Means on spine we will be sitting, lying down, and again we will lift the same pose in sitting position. This is prone pose. So we can do the same posture Navkasana in backside also. So this reduces your buttocks fat, thighs, and your calf muscle. So at the same time, your abdomen, your complete weight will be your body weight completely on your abdomen. So this is the posture of Navkasana, and this is Halasana. Halasana, I think so many are in different languages here. In Telugu, they'll be telling Nagali. The farmer will be digging in the fields. That is called plow pose. Halasana means in English we'll call as plow. This look at him. He is asana. This asana looks like plow. So in this plow pose, we'll lift our legs up. We're stretching completely here. Look at the legs straight. Knee should be straight. You should stretch your knees, and then you should go for this. When your complete body will be on your shoulders and your neck. Weight will be on your shoulders and neck. So in this pose, if you are not, because when you are having obesity, if your spine is stiff, you cannot do this position. You can do little bit, how much you can do it. When you do Kriya Navkasana daily, regularly practice the Kriya Navkasana first, and then you can do this plow pose, so that your body will be flexible and your shoulder and neck will be strong. Then you can go for this Halasana. You can lift slowly like this, and you can stay you can go to that position and you can come back, because no need to stay in the basic level. So after daily practice, you can stay for few seconds like this. 30 seconds you can stay, or 5 seconds you can sit. That depends on your strength. So obesity, let us know some more things about obesity. Obesity could be due to some hormonal malfunctions of endocrine glands. There should be proper balance between metabolic and hormonal function of the body. So yoga practice neither requires any machines nor much space. Yoga has the solution for a healthy lifestyle. It is a complete package with wonderful cardiodynamic workout. Meditative posture of influence on one's behavior and lifestyle. Regular practice of asana, pranayama, and kriya lead to a holistic lifestyle. And now we'll go for kriyas, because now we came to know some information about pranayama and asanas, and about obesity and the diet. Now, what is kriyas? Here we are seeing the practice of asana. We have gone through the PPT of asana, pranayama, and now we are going for kriyas. What is kriyas? So this is the pattern of body fat distribution. So abdominal android, lower body gynoid. This is a male body and this is female body. You can see when the male body is getting when he's with obesity problem. So look at him, his body will be looking like this, where the places they are getting obese problem, more excess fat there. You can see here, and here for ladies, you can see one from thighs. After that, they will get the problem in abdomen, and then waist, and then biceps. those things slowly, they will be one by one, we will be getting increasing the body weight. So this is the process we will be increasing our obese. Next, gynecoid, lower body obesity, pear shape, just now we had seen, increased by estrogen and progesterone, and a less health risk than upper body obesity. After menopause, some upper body obesity appears. So nowadays, obesity with who are getting obesity in ladies, they are facing more problems in after menopause time, after 50s. Some people nowadays, because they are having more knowledge in system lab online, so they are checking in systems online classes, that what the problems are going to face before menopause and after menopause. So they are taking care some people, and some people are getting tense. So nothing to tension, because menopause is a, that is natural thing which happens for ladies, so don't worry about that. Now, under upper body obesity, apple shape. So now we are seeing that pear shape and this apple shape. So associated with more heart disease, HDN, type 2 diabetes, abdominal fat is nowadays abdomen, nowadays diabetic is, we are seeing most of the people, and obesity also. So these are regular problems we are facing. Abdominal fat is released right into the liver. Increased by testosterone and excessive alcohol intake. So defined as waist measurement of 40 for men and 35 for women. So many are taking alcohol. So they are increasing the fat levels, obesity. They can't control the alcohol, taking alcohol. So they take, when they are taking alcohol, they take some spices and just like non-veg items, and they will be getting over excess of fat and obesity. So yoga has all the therapeutic benefits to reduce obesity and prevent related diseases. Yogic kriyas, cleaning, are the great benefits when we are going to for kriyas now. So benefit of internal cleansing of the entire digestive system. Kriyas like Vamandavati, Vastradavati and Bastis Kriya are a few techniques to cleanse the digestive tract and the rectum. So kriyas, actually so many people don't know about kriyas. So there are Shat Kriyas, and some people know some normal cleansing kriyas like that. So what is kriyas? Before going for yoga therapy, treatment, we'll start with cleansing techniques. When we are starting from cleansing techniques, then you can get the excellent benefit of the obesity. So when some people will be going for some ashramas or some health nature cures, so there will be giving them some exact what is the diet they are giving, and they'll be doing the cleansing techniques, that is kriyas. And they'll be doing exercise, body exercises and pranayamas in time. And at what time they are going to do, they'll be in everything in time, and how much they should take, everything in quantity. They will give the food in time and in the perfect measurement diet. So they'll be reducing, they'll get the result when they go to nature cures. But the same thing we are not able to do at our home. So if you are doing the same thing in your houses, you need not go for nature cures or anything else. You make it as a habit, daily habit, that taking good diet and take good food and do yoga and do the kriyas and take pranayama, anything. All these things, if you make that as a daily life, you can go through all problems easily. You can come out of the all problems. So we are going for know about the kriyas. When the inner organic body is clean, that's what I told now, when we'll do the kriyas, we'll start from nauseous, that I'll go for next. I'll see it. I'll tell you. The systems function properly. Kriyas are specially intended to get rid of the bodies of excess toxins and fat. So say Sirmulu advised that one should eat half the stomach full, drink water a quarter, and leave the rest empty. This will keep the yogi or any human being in harmony and serenity with the body, mind, and the soul. So I think you can understand this. So when the inner organic body is clean and healthy, when we are doing the kriyas, our inner body will be clean and will be healthy. So we will not clean the inner body. We'll take some diet and we'll do for some exercise for completely outside body. But inner body, we are not taking care, because we are not cleaning our inner body. Daily we are washing, we'll do the face wash, we'll bath, everything. We'll clean our teeth, everything, we'll brush our teeth. So these things we are doing. But internally, our organs are not, we are not cleaning them. So that toxins will be clean, then our fat will be completely gone. So here, why we are taking the half the stomach full? In night, actually, we'll be taking our process of eating, daily we're taking food, is completely different. That is the main reason we are getting obesity. And what the job we are doing, just like software jobs or night duties, those things we should avoid. Because of the software jobs and night duties, we'll get the obese problem very quickly and acidity problems also. In this place, in the lunch time, we are taking at 1 to 2 o'clock, in between 1 to 2. At the same time, we'll be skipping our breakfast sometime. And the night time, we'll be going for dinner after 10, 11, 12 also. So like that, there is no time, we are not following the times of food. So in the night, when we are taking the food at 10 o'clock, we should sleep at 11 or when you are taking 10 o'clock, you should take only little, just like some fruits like that you can take and you can sleep after half an hour. If you are taking any food roti like that, you should stay for 2 hours. Then you can sleep. Because before 2 hours, after 2 hours, we are not able to sleep, because we'll get immediately, because already it's too late. So we'll take full heavy food. Some people, most of the people will be taking 2 times rice only, and most of the people will be taking 3 times rice like that. So if you will take 1 time morning breakfast, and afternoon for lunch you can take rice, even you can take some pulkas, anything, only little bit. And when you are eating in the lunch time, you can eat full heavily, because you are having more time to sleep dinner time, so you can take it. So in the same way, in the night time, you can take half food which you are taking in the lunch time. Half of the lunch food you are taking in the dinner. So then you will get, digestion will be easy and your abdomen will not increase. So this helps the food habits. We can go next in some other time. Next, various postures, especially forward bending, twisting, and backward bending, help reduce fat near abdomen, hips, and other areas. One should learn all the correct methods with guidance from a proper yoga teacher. So why this is, everyone should know about this, various postures which we are doing asanas without teacher. When they are seeing any videos or they are seeing without any yoga teacher, they are facing so many problems. Because when you are doing, you are not doing with breath. And when you are going, you are not staying in normal breath. When you are going and coming back posture, you are not taking in landing pleasantly. Some people will take the posture slowly. They will go to the posture slowly. But when they are coming back, suddenly they will drop the posture. In that time, they will face the problems. So that one you should not go. So now we'll go for here the mudras. These mudras, I can show you this. Some are mudras. This is Surya Mudra. In this mudra, she can stay for 15 minutes when you hold the fingers. This is Surya Mudra, which you are folding your thumb finger. You are folding with your ring finger with your thumb finger. You are pressing your ring finger to with your thumb finger. So like this, you should keep your Surya Mudra. This increases your Agni Tattvam. Agni Tattvam melts your obesity, your fat. Agni melts your obesity. So this is the Agni Mudra. Surya Mudra, Agni Mudra will be like this. You can see here Surya Mudra. You can bend your, fold your ring finger, pressing with your thumb finger. Okay, other three fingers will be straight. This is the posture. You can see this one you can keep for 15 seconds, for 15 minutes. Each mudra you can do for 15 minutes. This is Linga Mudra. Linga means, you know, so you can do like this. You can hold your interlock your fingers completely and raise the thumb finger. This is Linga Mudra. You can do this for 15 minutes. Anytime you can go for mudras. No time being, any restrictions are there. So you can go anytime for mudras. But you can stay stable, silently, with concentration you should do. And whenever you do, whatever you do with positive thinking. Don't be in negative thinking so that you'll get the results fast and easily. So this is Linga Mudra. I think you can see in the PPT also, and you can, I'm showing in my hands. Next, now one is Surya Mudra and other is Linga Mudra. Next one, Kafanasika Mudra. Kafanasik Mudra means we are folding our little finger and ring finger. Okay, the index finger and middle finger is out. So we are pressing our little finger and ring finger, and we are keeping like this. This is Kafanasika Mudra. This one decreases your kapha also. This is Kafanasika Mudra. You can see in PPT here. This is Kafanasika Mudra. You can see here ring finger and little finger is folded. You are pressing your both the little finger and ring finger with your thumb finger to your palm, and your index finger and middle finger is showing straight up. In this posture also, you can stay for 15 minutes. Next, we'll go for Vayu Mudra. Vayu means air. Air, we are holding the, completely, you are releasing the air here. Like this, your index finger, you are folding to your palm and you are pressing with your thumb finger. And your three fingers straight. This is Vayu Mudra. This Vayu Mudra means air. So this is also, this one also you should do for, you can do for 15 minutes. If you can't do also, you can take for 5 minutes, you can hold and you can release. And again, you can increase for 10 minutes. Like that, you can slowly increase, no problem. Don't think that for 15 minutes you should stay, we can't stay like that. Next, we'll go for Gyan Mudra. Gyan Mudra means just fingertips of your thumb finger and index finger. You should fold like this. This is, and the other three fingers should be straight. This is Gyan Mudra. Like this. Whatever, when you are doing the prayer or when you are doing anything, you can keep like this. When you are doing pujas also, some people will be keeping like this. So that this is called Gyan Mudra. This index finger and thumb finger tips should be touched like this. Only tips. Tips only. Some people will be doing like this. Some people will be keeping like this. This goes to another mudra. So keep in mind, when you are folding like this, when you are folding like this, and when you are folding like this, this indicates different types of mudras. Keep that in mind. Gyan Mudra means just your tips, both the tips, index finger tip and thumb fingertip should be touching like this, pressing the tips. and the index straight middle finger and ring finger and little finger should be straight. This is a posture of Jnan Mudra. Next, Prana Mudra. Prana Mudra, it increases our energy levels. So this is Prana Mudra. Your little finger and your ring finger and thumb finger. These three fingers we are touching, pressing, and then your two index finger and your middle finger will be straight. This is called Prana Mudra. Got it? Next. So these things we can go for now. Asanas I will show you, and the pranayamas also I will show you. If you are having any doubts, you can ask in the last, in whatever language you can ask, in Telugu, Hindi, English, Tamil, anything. I will answer you. And now we'll go for asanas. I will show you the asanas, how to do, how we'll go for asanas in the starting. We'll go from Tadasana. I will show you. Now you can see the PPT is not needed exactly for you, okay? So I'll show clearly how to go for asanas. Minimize the screen. Yeah, is it okay? Can you see me? Yeah, now I'll show you how to do Tadasana and Trikonasana. We'll go for Tadasana first because our body completely will be activated. So we'll go for Tadasana first. Keep our legs apart, not touching each other, just little bit. Legs, because this is obesity class. When we are with obese, we can't stand with legs together joined. We can't stay. We can't balance. So that is the thing I'm telling, to keep your legs apart so that your weight can be balanced. So now legs apart and take your hands here. Stretch your fingertips and then go with count. 30 count you can take. Because we are not having much time in this our webinar, so I am taking without count. So slowly you can count 30 seconds just like before I showed you. And after 30 seconds, you can stay here for 30 seconds. Your biceps and ears should touch. No gap in between your biceps and ears. You can take your biceps back of your ears. Because of heaviness of your shoulders, you can't keep your hands back. You can push your hands back. So your hands will be coming forward like this. So I'll show you in the side pose. Your hands will come like this, front. So some people can do like this. So slowly you can take, you can push your hands back and your biceps and ears will be together. So this is the posture we are going to do. Your biceps and ears should be together. So in this position, you can turn like this, turning to sides in Tadasana. I told you before in the PPT, when I'm going through PPT, I told in Tadasana, we'll do some different variations like this. These are those variations. So like this, you should turn, you should twist our body from our waist.
and at the same time we should adjust our spine like this. We should adjust and stretch our body. When we are doing like this, we are shaking our spine like this because your spine will adjust and you can stretch more. So now slowly coming back, you can count 30 seconds when you are doing. Now we will go for Trikonasana, second one, second asana. Stretch your both the legs as much as you can stretch. You can split your legs. Your hands here, maximum how much your palms are going, that much you should stretch your legs also. If you can't stretch more, then you can go for as much as you can, little bit inside. Now turn your right toe sideways so that that is, your heel should be in between your other foot. Then you can go turn like this as much as you can go. If you can go this much only, from here we are going slowly, this much you can go, this much only, because of the waist obesity we can't go much. Then you can go how much you can go, you can, no problem. You can go for this posture. If you can't go this much, you can go here also. You can hold like this. Slowly you can go. When your body is flexible, you can go down and hold your ankle. If you can keep your hand down also, you can keep. But without bending your knee. Okay? Now slowly with your and up, and then straighten your toe. Exhale, drop your hands. So in the same way for doing this, we can do this with breath also. Starting, I'm not telling by breath, because when you're starting level, you can't keep your concentration on the breath at the same time on the posture. So I showed you the posture, how to go and how to come back. So now I'm telling with breath in the, when you are doing the second side, other side, I'm telling with breath. So let us do with breath. Open your legs. Stretch your legs. Maximum how much you can take. Like that. Before we are done, open your legs. And then keep your hands side. Inhale and stretch your hands up. Okay. Exhale. Now this side we turn the toe. Now we are bending this side, so you turn the toe this side, left side. Okay, here. Now we are going, inhaling hands up, exhaling we are going down slowly sideways. You should not bend forward like this. Completely your body, your chest should be straight. You should look at up. The posture, you should go. Your knee should be straight. Don't bend your knee. Stay very normal breath. We exhale and bend it. After coming to this posture, we should stay for a few minutes in normal breath. Now slowly inhaling, coming back. Turning your toe straight. Exhale and dropping the back. So this way you should go with breath. So when you are doing, keep your concentration on your body. The 1 hour you are doing the workouts or half an hour, whatever it is, you keep your concentration on your body, how you are doing, where it is going, where which part is getting melted, which part is getting affected when you're doing the asana, right? Next, we'll go for another asana.
Tadasana we are done, and now we are going for Pavan Muktasana. This is the one Pavan Muktasana, and the next one is Uttana Padasana. We will go for this both now. Yes. So Pavan Muktasana and Uttana Padasana will go for sitting. So you can see.
Pavan Muktasana. You should lie down. Fold your right leg and fold your left leg. Join your both the legs, both the knees, and your heels to your buttocks. You take your buttocks near to your heels. Okay. Now take your knees to your chest. Inhale completely. Fill your abdomen completely with air. Inhale and exhale. Take your heels up and press. Now inhale your abdomen again, once again. Inhale, fill your abdomen with your
I'm again not audible, ma'am. Ma'am?
Lock your both the knees like this with your hands, and then exhale, take your leg up and touch your knees. In this position, in normal breathing, you should stay for a few seconds, just like 30 seconds, or if you can't stay for 30 seconds, you can stay for 15 seconds also. And then inhale, neck back. Exhale, your legs down to the ground. This is the position you should do Pavan Muktasana. Once again, I will show you Pavan Muktasana. Take your legs folded, knees folded. And then slowly we'll go for position from here. This is the position. Take your knees, your thighs to your abdomen and interlock your hands to your knees. Inhale and press your legs to your abdomen completely. Press your abdomen with your thighs so that your gas will be coming out from your anus muscles. Keep your anus muscle open. Don't close your anus muscles wantedly, please. Don't open your anus muscles. Now inhale, press your abdomen. Exhale, lift your neck up and touch your knees. How much you can take near to your knees, you can take. If you come this much, it's okay. No problem. If you can take more, it's so best. So try to take your neck towards your knee. That is the thing you should do. In normal breath, we should stay here. And then inhale back. Exhale, release your legs. Normal breath, relax for a while, take your legs straight, keep your hands, palms facing up and relax for a while. Complete inhale and complete exhale. Now, slowly, I will show you how to do Pavan Muktasana as a here, just like an exercise. You can move some postures in this Pavan Muktasana. Just take your same, come to Pavan Muktasana position, hold your knees, take your knees to your abdomen and interlock your hands with your knees, around your knees, and then just roll up and down on your spine so that your gas, if your gas is not released, it will be released by moving up and down. You can do like this. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. This position, you can move, you can roll on like this, up and down. When you roll on like this, you will get released from your gas. So this is the position you can do. So in the same position, we roll up and down now. Now we are going to do sideways. So sideways, how we are moving, you can see. Interlock same, both the legs and both the hands. And then roll like this sideways. And go second side same way. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Keep your anus muscle loose, open, and then you should go for this Pavan Muktasana. Don't hold your anus muscles. So this way, question, count up and down also the same way. So slowly coming back. Now this is called Pavan Muktasana. After doing every asana, you should relax. Don't start immediately the another asana. You should go relax for a while and then you should do another asana. Complete inhale, complete exhale. When you are inhaling, your abdomen out. When you are exhaling, abdomen in. Now we'll go for Uttan Badasana. Your hands on the mat. Now slowly lift your toes up. If you can't raise both the legs at a time like this, you can go for single leg also. First you practice with single leg. One by one. Without bending your knee, take to 90 degrees. If you are not able to do 90 degrees also, you can do as much as possible you can do, but without bending your knee. If you are having knee problems, then you can do as it is possible for you, because some people will be having knee problems who are having obese. So you can take care of your knees and you can do slowly, no compromise when you're having any other problems. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Are you able to hear my voice clearly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, take both the legs at a time. Inhale, slowly up. You can stretch your toes when you're lifting up. Look at the legs. Knees will be straight. And back of your knees also, you can see this. It is straight or it is bending. You can watch this. So you can Stay in this position for few seconds. And now slowly drop your legs down. When you are coming back, you should land slowly. Relax. Your palms facing up and then legs apart. Give 1 foot gap in between your both the feet and relax. Relaxing, 1 foot gap should be in between your both the legs and palms facing upwards. Your body completely relax. Inhale completely, exhale completely. In the same Uttara Padasana, some people will be doing with hands and legs. That also you can do. There are different types of variations in each asana. So you can take hands up. Now in this position, you can lift your one hand and one leg up. Opposite hand and opposite leg. If you are lifting right hand and left leg, you should lift. This is the position. You should lift your opposite hand and opposite leg at a time up. You should stay for few seconds in normal breath. And again, from 30 seconds or 15 seconds or 1 minute also you can stay. Now slowly coming back, landing equally. Now we'll go for other hand, other leg. Second leg and second hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stay there for a few seconds. As per your capacity, you can stay for 15 seconds or 30 seconds or 1 minute. So day by day, you should increase the time being your staying capacity. And rounds also. Slowly exhale, drop your hand and leg equally. Relax. Now we have done alternative hand and leg. Now we are going to do both the hands and both the legs at a time. We should lift up. So inhale, stretch your hands and legs and then start lifting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stay there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. You can, when you're staying in the position, your legs, you can, your toes can be with towards your side also, no problem. When you're staying, that affects more when your toes are coming towards your side. Okay, so if you are stretching also, you can do, no problem. But if you lose, you can keep normal also. As your capacity, you can do it. Now landing slowly. When you are coming back, this is very important. You should not drop your heels suddenly down. Because of the heaviness of your thighs, you will drop your legs suddenly. But don't do that. Try to land your, keep your heels slowly down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Slowly drop. This is the position we should drop our, we should land our body. Come back to normal position, relaxing position. This is Uttana Padasana. Now you can come to again relaxing position, legs apart, 1 foot gap in between both the legs and your palms facing towards sky and inhalation and exhalation in normal breath. Inhale abdomen out, exhale abdomen in. So this is the Uttana Padasana. Now we will go for Bhujangasana. Bhujangasana, we should go. Now we have done the asanas on our spine, supine postures. Now we are going for prone posture. Prone posture means lying down on your abdomen. So we are turning to right side and stay for a while. For a few seconds, you stay in turning, and then we should come to prone posture. In Telugu, we will say borla padukodam. Potta meer chese asanalu. Now in this posture, you can go for legs together, stretch your toes, and now lie down first. Keep your forehead or chin on the ground, because some people can't keep their forehead on the ground. So you can keep your chin also, no problem. Those who are having cervical spondylitis, they can't stay. The cervical spondylitis people can't keep their forehead, so they can keep the chin. So in from this position, you can come to Bhujangasana posture. Take your hands beside, elbows to your ribs, and the palms before your face. I mean, beside your face. Now from here, slowly lift your neck up. Lift your chest and shoulders, shoulder and chest slowly up. Stay there if you can here. And if you want the elbow support, you can keep like this, and you can go this. Here. This is Sarpasana. You can keep your elbow support straight here, and then stay. Your chin and face should be straight. This is Sarpasana. We'll say this as Bhujangasana also. Slowly drop your neck up, chest down. So neck and chest downwards, and come to Makarasana, relaxing posture. Take your legs apart, toes outside, heels inside, and you can keep your chin or forehead on the palms, on your hands. And relax for a while. Take normal breath. After relaxing, you can go for another asana. That is called, after Bhujangasana, now we have done Bhujangasana. After Bhujangasana, next, what is the asana? What is the asana? Next one, after Bhujangasana, Shalabhasana. Shalabhasana, we have done Bhujangasana, lifting our neck up, upper body, we had lifted the upper body. That means, in Bhujangasana, our upper body is lifted. Now we are going to lift our legs, our lower body. So we are going for Shalabhasana. Shalabhasana, again we are going this Shalabhasana on our abdomen. This is also prone posture. We are taking our palms under our legs. I mean, under our thighs. You can take like this. And keep your chin. Keep your chin on the ground and your palms under your thighs. Now, keep in this position. Relax in normal breath. And now, inhale. Lift your legs without bending your knees. Inhale and then lift up. Stay in normal breath. Few seconds. Slowly coming down. Relax. The same, if you are not able to do at a time with the both the legs, you can do with single leg. I will show the basic level also. Now I showed the posture which we had seen in the PPT. Now we are going to see the basic level with obese. Actually, obese people who are not flexible, they can't do with both the legs without bending knees. So now I will show the basic how you can do, because everyone can't do the same just like what I had done now. So in the starting, in the basic, how you can start, I will show you. You can practice like this. Keep your hands like this. If you can't lift it, you can go. If you can't keep your thighs, if your palms are heavy, if your thighs are heavy, if your palms you are not able to keep under your thighs, then you can keep aside also. No problem. Like this also you can keep. If you can keep under the thigh, you can keep. Okay. This is basic level I am telling now for your comfort. Now keep your chin on the ground and lift one leg up.
Hello, hello.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. First, slowly drop your leg down. Like this, you can lift another leg. You can keep your chin on the ground and lift your another leg. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Slowly down. Like this. Relax again. Don't worry. Then you can't do. You can start basic wise. Don't be in hurry. Okay. Now we're going to another asana. What is the next? Bhujangasana will complete it and Shalabhasana that opposite. Now we are going for Kamar Chakrasana. Kamar Chakrasana. We are going in sitting posture. Yeah, can you hear me? I got the power now. Are you able to hear?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now we are doing the sitting posture. Kamar Chakrasana. Kamar Chakrasana means we are rotating our waist. So I will show you in this Kamar Chakrasana. Split your legs completely. How much you can split, you can split. Then, now first straighten your spine and then now relax, push your chest forward, make your spine straight, shoulders back, okay? Now your spine is straight. So just turn this side and that side because you should relax your spine. When you are rotating, you may get some pains. So please take care when you are doing this Kamar Chakrasana. Now take your hand, right hand up, take your left hand back. See, my left hand is opposite side. Okay. So take your right hand to your left leg. First, I'm showing you slowly
so that you can come to the position safe, so without any pains. So this is the posture you should do. Now again from here we will go to another side. We will change the hand like this, like just like a chakra. We should change our hand also, and again bending other side. Now again my hand is around the waist back side here, you can see, and my hand opposite side, opposite leg. Now I'm bending little forward, so try to do like this. Slowly you can stretch your upper body, come to this position. Slowly you can go again like this. 1, 2, swing just forward like this. Slowly, gently, you can move your spine up and down so that your body will become flexible. Don't hurt your spine when you are bending forward. Just go slowly, gently, and come back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So you can increase your rounds doing this. First day you can't do more, so just start with slowly, gently moves, and then daily you can increase. If you are flexible also, don't try for fast movements or don't try for pushing your, hurting your spine. Okay, now I'll show the next asana after our Tama Chakrasana. We'll go for next. Now we are doing the sitting asanas. So we'll go for next. Next one.
Marakatasana.
Yeah. I should go for this.
Next one is Marakatasana. After Marakatasana, we'll go for Vajrasana. Okay. Now, Marakatasana. I'm going for Marakatasana again, lying down. Take your hands sideways up to your shoulder level. Your hand, shoulder level, and lift your right hand to your shoulder level. Both the hands should be shoulder level, sideways like this. And now you lift your left leg up 90 degrees. Then take your left leg to right side, but your left shoulder and left hand should not lift. Try to take, and if you can hold your toe, you can hold like this, but your both the knees should be straight. Your head should be straight. You should look at the roof. So again, inhale, lift your legs straight up, and then exhale, drop your leg down. So in the same way, you can do it to the other side also. So I'll show the second side. Now take your hands, shoulder level. Now you are going to lift the right leg. Lift your right leg up 90 degrees and then take your right leg to your left hand. Both the knees should be stretched. Your head should be straight, facing towards your roof. Now stay there for a few seconds. Some people can stay for 15 seconds. Some may stay for 30 seconds. Still, if they are more flexible, they can stay for 1 minute. Now inhale, lift your leg up slowly, knee straight, and come to standing position and 90 degrees. And then exhale, slowly drop your leg, land your leg slowly, gently to the mat. Relax and take your hands sideways. Relax for a while. Keep your breath in normal, because when you're staying in the posture, your breath is normal, but it increases our blood pressure because we are twisting our body, your legs, your hands completely. So now slowly turn into your sideways and then coming to another asana, Vajrasana. So we are coming to side pose, and whenever you are coming back to sitting position from lying down, you should turn sideways and stay for a few seconds, and then you should come to sitting position. Suddenly don't jump or don't get up very fast. That is very dangerous for our health. So slowly take your hand support and lift your body up and come to sitting position. Now we are going to do Vajrasana. In Vajrasana, we are coming to sitting position. So Vajrasana, how we should come? I will show you in side pose first, so that you can see my legs, how I am taking. So I will take, see the, you can see the legs. Both the toes like this, heels apart, and sit in between your both the knees, in between your both the knees. Rendu kaalu madavar madhyalo kurchuva. Your buttock should be in between your both the knees. In this position, you should sit comfortable. Then you should lift your spine up. Sit straight like this. So the same position I am showing in the sideways now. This is the position we should sit. In Vajrasana, we are sitting. This is very good for our health. I told the benefits of the Vajrasana and where we are getting affected. So now I am showing this Vajrasana. You can sit like this for a few seconds. If you are not able to sit like this, you can go, if you are not able to sit on the mat or on the ground, no need to sit on the hard surface. Take any bed sheet or any pillow and you can sit comfortably. If your ankles are paining, if your ankles are stiff, you can't sit in this position in the hard surface. So you can keep some cushion or any pillow or any bed sheet or any towel. You can fold or you can keep under your knees, and wherever you are pain, wherever you are not comfortable, in that places you can keep the cushion or bed sheet, towel, anything as per your comfort. And see the spine from the tailbone to my head, cervical. My spine should be straight. This is the position we should sit. You can sit on bed also, No problem. If you are not comfort on hard surface or on the mat, you can sit on the on your mattress. No problem. But the mattress should be comfort correct mattress you should use. So this is the position called Vajrasana. You can sit in this daily practice. This is very good. Vajrasana means diamond for diamond. This your body will become hard just like a diamond. That is why this is called Vajrasana. Vajrasana means hard just like a diamond. Your body will become hard. So that is the reason we will do Vajrasana. This is good for digestion. This is good for our joints. So this is very good for obesity also, because we will not sit in this position comfortably. Who are obese because of the heavy weight, they will feel uncomfortable in this position. So we can do as your comfort. Okay, next one. What is the next asana we are going to do?
Okay. Paschimottanasana.
Yeah, okay. Paschimottanasana, okay. Next, Paschimottanasana and Purvottanasana. Okay. Next, we are going to do Paschimottanasana. Right? This is again we are going for sitting position, because the order is not comfort, so we are going for sitting prone supine like that. Next, Paschimottanasana. Sit in comfortable posture like this. And now slowly take your spine straight, your shoulders back, chest forward. This is the sitting posture we should do first. Then like this. Now take your hands up, but your spine will be the same position. Spine should be straight. Inhale, stretch your hands up. Make your body straight in L shape. And now inhale and then exhale, bend forward. Take your waist down, your abdomen. After that, your chest. After that, your forehead. Take your hands towards your toe. See my hands, how much it is going, but try how much you can do, that's enough, because don't force your back, just push your waist like this. You can move some small stretchings like this, then you can go for straight, because in the first time when you go for at a time to the Paschimottanasana, you may get some pains. So don't hurt your spine. So slowly exhale. Try to push your waist forward, chest down, and then hold your toes, and then try to keep your forehead on your knees. Stay normal breath. Now slowly inhale, back up. Take your hands forward. Inhale, slowly come up. Now again, straight in L shape, and then slowly exhale. Drop your hands from sideways. This is called Paschimottanasana. Slowly, day by day, you can increase your capacity. Don't hurt your spine. Please, I'm telling again and again, obesity people can't do exact complete posture at a time in the starting itself. So it takes time. So do slowly. Now, let us go for next asana. What's next? What is next asana?
Purvottas.
What is that?
Purvottasana.
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 Purvottanasana. So, I'll show. Yes. Next to Purvottanasana. This is the Purvottanasana posture. I think you can see. Purvottanasana, same again, sitting. We'll go for posture. I'll do this one. Yeah, we'll go for Purvottanasana after that. Navpasan. Halasana. Okay. So three more asanas. Right. Purvottanasana will go. This is Purvottanasana posture. Legs straight. Join your legs. Hands back. See here. In the PPT, I showed you hands are like this. You can keep like this or like this also, because some people biceps and triceps will be not equal. So that is the reason, as per their comfort, you can turn the palms. No problem. You need not worry about the facing of the palms. Okay. You can take the fingertips outside or inside. Okay. No problem. But I can do any side equal, no problem for me. But if you are not, which side is comfort for you, you can do that side, because it's not hurt your body. So keep your hands yourself back. Now lift your, stretch your toes and then lift your waist up like this. Stay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Slowly can come back. You should not bend your knees in this position. Don't bend your knees, because if you bend your knees, you can't get much benefit. So without bending your knees, you can do. So as much as you can do correctly, you try for that, but don't stress more. Going to posture and coming back also is very important. So try your level best, how much, because of the overweight, you can't stay for more much time, because your body weight will completely will be on your wrist. So you can relax for a while. Again, you can do more rounds, but try to stay how much time you can say that much. Okay, don't take any risks. Don't drop your waist suddenly down. Some people will be going fast and the same time they're coming back, they'll be dropping like this. In that way, you should not do. Please, I'm telling, please go slowly and come back slowly. Don't be in hurry. Lift slowly and gently come back. Inhale up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now relax, slowly drop your waist down. So like this, you can do the Purvottanasana. Now we'll go for next one. Then next asana.
Navakasana.
We are going. Navakasana, you can, I told you in the PPT, Navakasana is on, you can do on your abdomen. At the same time, you can do on your back, supine also. You can your body weight will be on your abdomen or your buttocks. Both you can do. In PPT, I showed you that is like this. So in PPT, that is in abdomen. So I will show you now on the back side how to do in the opposite, on the side also. Because you can see in the Navakasana in the abdomen side. Now I will show lying down on the supine. So this one also you can do. Or else you can do. You can lift your hands and legs slowly up like this. You can take your hand support also. In this position, you can stick. But your hand level and toe level should be equal. Then only we'll get that vibration and we'll get excess fat will be burned. Slowly drop your hands and legs. Relax for a while because your complete body weight is on your abdomen and your buttocks. So now you can slowly come back. The same posture I'll show on your abdomen also if you want. But next, one more asana is there. We'll go for Halasana. Halasana, this is who are having cervical problem. They should go for their comfort level. Don't hurt yourself because who are having cervical problem, they should avoid this complete posture. Just they can go and come back. But don't stay in the Halasana position or Sarvangasana position. They should avoid. So don't do when you are having cervical problem. I'll go down because you can't see my legs. So I am going down a little bit. Now from here, you can lift your legs up and take your hands down. Take the support of your hands under your waist. So you can go like this. You can adjust and you can take the support of your hands and lift your buttocks, waist and back up. So slowly go back, lift your spine, buttocks up and stay in this position. And if you are comfort, you can go for your posture completely like this. You can interlock also. You can stay for a few seconds. Now slowly take your hands to your waist and then slowly drop your each and every vertebra. Slowly drop your vertebras down. Landing should be gentle. Come slowly and keep relax your legs and slowly come down. But slowly here I'm dropping my hand with my legs with folding because space is not comfort. So the landing should be the same like this. From here, the landing should be the same, straight without bending your knees. So this is the way you should do the Halasana. But if you are having any cervical problem, please avoid, or you can do just normal up and down movements, but don't stay in Halasana. Complete posture lo vellin tarvata you should not stay. Relax. Now turn to sideways and then stay for a few seconds like this. When you are getting up from bed also, you should turn to side, stay for a few seconds, and then you should get up, because the blood circulation to the heart will come to normal position. Then only you should come to sitting position after bed. From lying down, you should come gently. Now, we will go for next pranayama, I think. Or is that time? Yeah, it's time off, I think, 1:20. Yeah, if you're having any doubts, Joe, I think any questions in chat box? I'll answer.
Thank you, ma'am. What an energy. Since 2 hours, we have been saying this class. Thank you so much for you and your core team. Hope we have a great session today. Yes, if anybody have any doubts, you can please comment in the chat box. A small announcement. Tomorrow's class is going to be held by Mallika Devi Garu, and it is about yoga for mental well-being. Hope you all guys attend tomorrow's class, and ID, password, and link will be sent to you by evening by Lanka Satyanarayan Garu. Okay, we will end today's session with a prayer by Lanka Satyanarayan Garu. Sir, please.
Thank you, Kiran Deepthi. Anybody have questions? Please ask to ma'am.
Hello. Hello, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
How much time gap should be there for doing the exercise after evening, after having a lunch, or evening practice?
One second.
Madam?
Yeah, come on. Chat box. Yeah, you can ask me. What is the question, please?
How much time gap should be there after food for doing the exercise in the evening practice?
For the evening practice after lunch, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah, yeah.
After lunch, you should give gap for 4 hours, please.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Okay.
Any questions?
Hi, ma'am. Good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon, ma'am.
Ma'am, what's your opinion how the yoga works on the heritage or genetic-based obesity, ma'am? So familial tendencies there. My father have obesity. My mother have obesity. Okay. So how to prevent obesity for me?
Yeah. Like that, are you doing any physical exercise, any yoga or anything else?
Yes, ma'am. I'm a BNOS doctor, ma'am.
Oh, good. So that is not compulsory that your parents are having, so that you will also get in like that. That is not compulsory.
Yes,
because
ma'am.
If you are doing the physical exercise and the diet is correct, you are going correctly, then you will not get that. So don't be in that way that your parents are having. That will be in genetic way. Because to be frank, I will be telling my experience for everyone. That my parents and my mother's side and my mother-in-law's side, all problems like diabetes and obese, everything. But I'm not, now I am 45 plus, I got my granddaughter also. So, but as per God's gift, I am healthy. I did not get any diabetic or BP or anything else. I am perfectly all right. So don't go in that way. You continue your yoga. That is very best in any physical exercise. Yoga is the best. That one I can give 100% guarantee. So if you do the yoga daily part in your life,
then no problem will come for you. And don't go anything that don't feel in negative way that our parents are having or their grandparents are having, that we will also come in genetic way. Don't think that.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
If you are not able to ask in English, you can ask in Telugu, Hindi, English, Tamil, any language. I can reply for you. If you are not comfort with English also, you can talk in Telugu, English, Tamil, Hindi. Okay?
Okay, thank you, ma'am, for spending your valuable time here.
Thank you very much for giving this opportunity. I'm very happy that I had given my knowledge for you all. Yes?
Ma'am, laparoscopic surgery is the cause of obesity, ma'am. Is there a chance? Family plan operation?
If you do the laparoscopic operation, so you'll get obese.
Is there a chance of obesity? Is that the reason for a woman?
No, that is not the reason at all.
Only physical activity.
I'm telling about myself that I had done that operation, but I'm looking okay, isn't it? Not much, but I'm okay. I'm healthy. I might not get any obese, isn't it?
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Any particular pranayama is there for obesity?
Yeah, I don't do so many pranayamas. Just a minute, I will tell you once again. Are you not there in this meeting from first? Excuse me?
Yes, ma'am?
You are not there from first in front of the meeting?
That time I were power cut. I cannot hear you, ma'am.
There are few pranayamas I'll tell now. You can do the Kapalbhati, Bhramari.
Okay.
Bhastrika,
okay.
Yes. Agnisar also you can do. Actually, I did not add the Agnisar in this PPT. So you can do the Agnisar pranayama also. You can do last Anulom Vilom pranayama also you can do. But the best asanas for obese is Kapalbhati and Agnisar and Bhastrika. With the abdomen movement, with exhalation and inhalation, with abdomen movements, you should keep your concentration and you should do it.
Okay, Kapalbhati, Bhastrika.
Kapalbhati, Bhastrika, Agnisara.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Ma'am, only pranayam, yoga, asana, lose the weight, ma'am.
Only pranayama and asanas, huh?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yeah, you can reduce the weight, but the diet also is important. Because when you're putting in everything, we will be telling that our body is like it, we will feel that this is a test bin. So when we are putting in inside everything, and when we are doing the workout, there we are putting inside and we are building up the obese, and here we are doing the workout, then that is the same. It will not reduce. That will be the same. So when you do the somewhat diet control, what we should eat, what we should not eat, then when we are doing the asanas and pranayama, definitely you will have the excellent results.
Okay.
But you need not use any medicines or any operations, anything. So that don't go for surgeries. That is very harmful and you'll get so many side effects, so many other problems you should face.
Okay, if doubts are completed, we will end this session with a prayer. And the prayer was given by Lanka Satchinarayan Garu.
Thank you, Kiran Dipti. Now, end with session. Omkara. Please chant along with me 3 times Omkara. deep inhale. Shanti Shanti Hi Arihi Om Tassat Om Namah Loka Samastha Sukhino Bhavantu. Thank you one and all.